Rockers, what's happening? All right. Let me set you up here quick. A little bit higher. I'm going to get a tilt down so you can see what the hell's going on. I actually started. I got the first freaking, as you can see, it's not, still not open completely. I started without you, so I'm sorry for that. This is not my piece of equipment. I know what's in it though. Obviously, oh, I'm sure you're about to find out too. Oh, they boxed it pretty good. Someone bought a security system. Sure as hell wasn't me. I live in a freaking country, man. I don't need no security system. So Dave, I'm sure you're gonna catch this video at some point or another, my friend. Sorry I weren't able to make it out all week. Hopefully you're... This is the Techniques RS-858DUS, which is the cousin to my RS-858US with the wood case that's hiding right back over there. You've seen it. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna pull that out quick. Let me move this table down. This has a case on it, which I have to make one for this one too. I gotta make the dimensions slightly smaller. As you can see, there's like an 1/8 inch gap on there. So you can see them real good now together. The obvious thing is, that one has more fancy buttons on it. Well, not more buttons, but more selectable items. There is no noise reduction circuit on this one, though. Which, honestly, isn't necessarily that big of a deal. They only get you so far on the 8-track decks anyway before you lose any of your... before you start losing your high end there. All right, so, as you guys can see... I'm going to have to crawl around this tripod now. As you guys can see... They look almost identical. There are some differences, though. Look on the back here. The obvious difference on the back is that... Take you off the tripod for a minute. Is that the 858DUS has an AC outlet on the back. The US does not. And also, the DUS is dual voltage. The DUS also can take the DIN inputs and outputs instead, whereas the US cannot. The reason I prefer the US over the DUS is because of the noise suppressor and the I like the blue. Now with a Sansui QRX 2600, which is what my boy Dave's going to be using, the dial lights up green, so that'll be a really good match. What we're going to do quick is I'm going to plug this in. So I'm going to put you back on the tripod for a second. I'm going to walk around the other side and we'll light it up. I just wish they put a power button on these. I know everyone says, oh yeah, but you put a tape in. Yeah, but it's nice to have it lit up without it. Because I like to look at the VU meters move even when I'm not listening to a tape or making a recording. It just looks cool with the VU meters. I don't think anybody would disagree with that. Are we going? Another question you guys are thinking: are we going to listen to it? Damn right we are. Of course, that's the name of my game. As I just made a mess here, I gotta clean that up before my equipment gets in it. So I'm just gonna disconnect this. Well, it should be the same, right? Line out, yep, front, rear, okay. And we're gonna use Dave's HVAC player instead of my HVAC player. It's a pretty simple switcheroo we're doing here. You guys already know what mine sounds like. Well, you have an idea what mine sounds like. These are not, the cameras don't do these things any justice. I'm sure you'll lose some quality when you transfer it to YouTube too. Let's see what would be a good sounding do a tribute to my one of my old videos of my 858 DUS that you can find on my old ass EYG2181 channel from God, years, like 13, 14 years ago. I don't know if I'm repeating it. So yeah, I'll go over this later. Let's just test it out and see if it works, see what our working status is first. Well, we got problems. That's right, yeah, it's got to fade in. Dragging like a bastard. Yeah, I'm gonna go on a limb and say this thing definitely needs a new belt at the very least. At the very least. Alright, let's try a different one. Sound quality's there though. You can tell it sounds good. Minus a roo roo roo. It needs a head alignment. Definitely needs a head alignment. Tape counter does not work. All right, so obviously the differences here are your headphone jack is the same, your tape counter is the same, your two channel and four channel display is also the same. You can see them both in action here. This would be a good picture. See what they look like, both lit up. I'm gonna do that just for display purposes for the video. So that's your big difference. Is your this one here has your AC out switch and switched selector, and that's for obviously for this the bobber here on the back. This is all the same over here. The VU meters are different, better on this one, I think. Although this one here, I can't deny, it's really sexy and bright. And green is actually my favorite color, so it actually doesn't make sense that I prefer these. For some reason, because this one, the US is a lot more rare, probably. Would be what it would set the difference apart for me. These are nicer VU meters. These ones are a little bit more basic. But again, that color is absolutely gorgeous. I'm not knocking the green. I'm just saying I just prefer, I slightly prefer the light blue. I don't know why. I just do. So the US has a noise suppressor. This one here actually gives you more options. This one here only gives you the option for continuous play and the pan eject, which self-explanatory there. They both do it. This one will just give you a little bit more options with it. So you can either have it on repeat, which this one actually does not give you an option for. It's either gonna, well, I guess it kind of does. I don't think it repeats. This repeat, I gotta figure out if this repeats the program or if it, no, it doesn't. This one just repeats the program over and over again, so it won't click tracks at all. Because it has your continuous play option right there. Okay. This one has a noise suppressor. This one gives you a program repeat in case you feel like listening to program one or two, or if it's a stereo tape, 1, 2, 3, or 4 over and over again. Your channel selector, your program selector, these are all the same. So both decks are extremely freaking gorgeous machines. They're very, this one here should be just as easy to work on. If you look, this one here has the model, the 4-channel and model number up there. This one has a 4-channel model number and a brand name. This one here, it says Techniques underneath instead of this one here, which says it up top. So they're all basically cosmetic. This is all the same. I got to figure out what's going on with that right there. I'll get the tape counter working for them. I'll get a new belt ordered for it. There are no speed adjustments on these, so hopefully when I get the right belt, hopefully it has the right tension on there. This one here, I had to order for mine. I had to order a slightly smaller belt for it to get it to work right. Realistically, I should get a new motor for it, and I should probably have it recapped too, because I actually believe his sounded a little bit better than mine, minus the fact that mine plays the speed's correct and it doesn't do that warbly thing. It could play through the longest tape I have, which is Dark Side of the Moon. Oh, not Dark Side of the Moon. I Wish You Were Here. Play through that, no problem, without even a hiccup. So, went over that. Your headphones are the same. This is all the same. The heads are immaculate on that. Same with mine here. Capstan looks just about the same, so. They're in about the same condition, honestly. 2-channel and 4-channel lights work on both of them, no problem. This one here, the channel selector works fine. This one here, I'm hoping with any luck, it's just going to be dirty, dirty contacts for the switch up top here on top of the head assembly. I'm hoping that's all it is. I think I went over all the differences. So 2-channel, 4-channel selector, program selector, eject, record, pause, and fast forward. They're all the same. This one here, and this gives you the eject option, which 1 to 4 or 1 to 2, depending on what. Or this one here will let you do it after each track too, or this one here only does it at the end of the tape. This one here is either program 1 to 2, or 1 to 4 when 1 to 4 plays, and then when 1 to 2 plays, when it's done playing a tape, it'll eject it for stereo or quad. That's based off of what you're set up for up here. Each, like I said, each is self-explanatory. Oh. Well, yeah, it does it with the, okay, cool. Continuous play. So each will do it every time. This one here will do it only after every, after I go through all the cycles. And it's a little bit off too. Somebody had it. And these are all off too. Somebody had this apart at one point. I'm hoping they didn't touch with any of the potentiometers, although, by the way, it sounds, when I was playing with it, it sounds pretty good. So there's a good chance that they spared me with their bullshit on messing with the potentiometers inside, hopefully. It definitely does need a head alignment though. I'm kind of pretty sure somebody was in there screwing around. Trying to get this on straight. There we go. Repeat. Oh, that's beautiful. Got that lined up pretty good. So you want that all the way over there. So let's do a sound comparison. We're gonna listen to the Aerosmith one more time and a Guess Who one more time. And then we'll hook mine back up and try it out and see what the difference in sound quality is, if any. I didn't really listen to mine today with that Aerosmith tape, so we're gonna leave the settings the same. Leave the volume the same. Gonna go through all three tapes again one more time. Actually, all four one more time. The Gray Warner Brothers tapes are hit or miss. Sometimes they sound decent. Sometimes they sound absolutely atrocious. The Columbia and RCAs are usually pretty reliable. And the sound quality, you can usually bet on them being pretty decent, at least acceptable. That is what people make fun of the 8-track for. Now, obviously, that is not normal operating condition for an 8-track tape. Lonely feeling. Playing a little slow. Deep inside. In all fairness, I had the freaking Aerosmith tape playing in stereo. This thing here has a pad for the metal spring off. So. That's unbelievable. I don't even have anything to say to that. That's unbelievably bad. We're gonna hook my deck back up, which we all know to be in perfect working order. And we'll try the same exact tapes again and compare the sound quality. I believe his might have sounded a little bit better. Of course, not, you know, minus the... We'll be right back. the sound quality is about the same. Mine actually might be a little bit brighter.
It was even brighter with the noise suppressor on. That's a freaking jam right there, Storm Trucking. Or Storm Trucking, Space Trucking. I got Stormbringer and Space Trucking confused. What an idiot. Come on! Quality on the Warner Brothers tapes isn't always the best. The Stormbringer sounded okay with Machine Head. Either the tapes played pretty heavily or just the recording level wasn't right, because there's a lot of tape hiss on there. Stormbringer sounded okay. The Guess Who and Aerosmith sounded great. So that's all we really got to talk about right now as far as these two go. I've got to put it back on so I can get a quick picture quick, and I'll take a picture of the front and the back compared. And yeah, that'll be it for this video. You'll see this unit again as I go through the process. Like I said, Dave wants a wooden case for it too, so I'll see if I can make his a little bit tighter. I was worried about it when I did mine. I might take mine apart again, cut a little bit off, but honestly, it doesn't look bad enough for me to really mess with it. Gives it a little bit of freaking breathing space, if anything, if you even want to call it breathing space. But yeah, this one here, the side panels on his are actually in really good shape, and it's really good shape physically too. I don't see any smoke damage at all, so I don't even have to take the faceplate off of, though. I probably will. I'll probably soak it in the scalding hot water, get it cleaned up the best I can for him. But yeah, it's really good physical shape. Keep in mind, if you go to buy one of these decks, they are 50 years old, if not close to 50 years old. They are going to need something. Like I said, you can't even knock this deck for that. This deck probably has been loved or taken care of or maintained in any way, shape, or form since before I was even born, so it's amazing it works at all. Like I said, mine had the motor mounts completely dry out of the way. Maybe there's a different rubber formula for that in the DUS, potentially. Maybe they use different rubber grommets. Like I said, some of the early A-Track tapes, especially the Ampex and Learjet carts, the pinch roller actually rotted out of the way and turned to tar. It makes a real mess out of your machine, too, if you put one of those tapes in. So, yeah, this one here, the obvious thing is cosmetic. These are all in the wrong position. They all need to be homed out. But I'm not even going to bother doing that until I take it apart, get the heads demagnetized, cleaned, do an alignment on it. I actually just got a test tape recently, too, which should really make the job a lot better and a lot easier. So that's all I got for now. Like I said, mess with that. Let me know what you think. What's your favorite one? What one do you like better? Providing they both work the same. Mine sounded like it was a little bit brighter fidelity-wise, which I like that, the brightness. But in all fairness, the heads are out of alignment. They look clean, but you never know.
I'll have to clean them up anyway and do a demagnetizing on them. Run the demagnetizer wand over it. So we'll see where we're at that point. I expect the sound quality to be right on par, about the same. Both of them smoke the Akai CR80 DSS. Sorry, guys, but they do. The Akai can be a good sounding machine when you tweak it, but they didn't hold up as good over time as these did. Just my personal opinion. Neither one of them have a speed adjustment, so I'll probably end up doing a motor change on both of them. I just got to source out a replacement for it. If you guys know what the RPMs are on these, please let me know. I'd love to find out, because I want to, like I said, I like to order replacement motors for them. That being said, I'll catch you next time. Peace out. Rock on. Questions, comments, concerns, drop me drop a comment on there.
I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Any questions? It does have a little bit of yellowing I can see in the light, so I'm gonna run the faceplate through Dawn soap, scalding hot water, like I did with mine. Go from there. Anyway, guys, catch you next time. Thanks for watching.